because I got no respect for him. Amen? I call him old Snaggletooth. Amen? Because he has no power and authority over you. You see, I was talking before and I was sharing that God is still the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. He never changes. What happens is, you know, people, the Bible says, and we're watching my video, people, if you don't know, you don't know, right? If you go to school, you got to study in order to get your education. Am I right or wrong, right? If you don't read and you don't study, if I want to know Natasha, I got to spend time with Natasha, nice, right? Yeah. I have to quote her and, you know, hang out together, right, and get to know who she is.
Right.
Amen. In order she knows who I am. Amen. Right. So we can become what? Into what?
One.
A relationship.
Right. Yes.
And that's what God wants from us, Jesus Christ. Is that right, Charles?
Yes.
He doesn't want you to be a religious person, because I'm not a religious person.
Amen.
I'm a relationship person. Mm-hmm. I say that all the time here because you got a lot of people that believe but don't have a relationship with God. You see, and it's important that we have a relationship with God, because when you have a relationship with somebody, it means that you know them. Is that an amen?
Amen.
Right, Mama Lola?
Amen.
Now, I want to talk about this. My title message today is what? And those watching my video, shoot the camera over. It's what? Let's say it together.
Faith
is what?
Not.
I meant to say not, but she wrote now.
Now.
Not.
Not.
Faith is not. Not now. That's the title is Faith is Not. Okay? Now let me say this, that sometimes it helps us to understand what something is by what? Looking at it, right?
Right.
I'm going to say that again. Sometimes it helps to understand,
looking at
it, right? What something is by what? Looking at it and what it is not. Amen. You see where I'm going with this. Faith is not holding on, right? And holding on by our own efforts. Amen. Until God moves on our behalf. I'm going to say that again. Faith is not holding on and holding on by our own efforts until God has moved in our behalf.
Amen.
Faith is, and I want you to write this down if you can, faith is knowing God and His will for our lives and having a joyful experience and knowing He who will do what He said He would do. Amen. If I promise you something, you're going to remember that. I promise I'm going to get you a car. I'm sorry, I like to use people. I'm going to get you a car. You're going to remember that. Right? Every time you see me, remember you told me. Why? Because you that's something that you want. Amen? You see where I'm going with this. Amen. So if we want to know God and we don't want to know the promises of God, we got to get into His Word.
Amen?
And we got to remember those promises. Now, sometimes you can say something to somebody, and down the road, as we get a little younger, we tend to forget. And then the kids will come up, Dad, you said this, or Mom, you said this, but I don't remember saying it, but you did say it.
Amen.
And honestly, because we get a little older, we don't remember.
Right.
Amen?
You're right.
Amen. So you don't, it's all right to laugh. Make me feel like I'm preaching to you. But what did He do? You know, You forget, right, Mama Lola? Sometimes, I know Mama Lola say, no, I'm okay, I never forget. That's all right. Some people do it, some don't.
Right.
But the thing is that you remind yourself. That's why the Bible says that we're to read it constantly and meditate on the word, what? Day, right?
And night.
And night. So it's 24/7. Amen?
Yes.
Amen.
Amen?
Amen.
So let me get into the message real quick because I want to go through it quickly. It says, faith is knowing God and His will in our lives. So we must have faith. Our faith to develop, we got to know the promises of God which are in His Word.
Amen.
And those watching by video. Amen. And knowing His will, what He has said that we can do. Amen. Now, faith is not a magic potion or magic wand that you can write around, by which we obtain a personal desire, right, from God, right?
Amen.
Instead, faith means to approach God with a firm confidence, right, humility, and most of all, this is the hard one, this is the new submission.
Amen.
Is that the truth, Mama Lord? Submission. Yes, I believe in God. Yes, I pray to the Lord. Amen. But are you submitted to Him? Amen. Are you following the commandments? The commandment says what? Keep the Sabbath day holy. Y'all know how I'm very onto that is keep the Sabbath day holy. That means to what? To obey the commandments the best that you can. Not to say that you're perfect, because I sure ain't perfect. You ain't perfect. None of us are perfect. The only one I knew, it was Jesus was perfect. And believe me, he got to that point too. If you read the scriptures, when he went to the Garden of Gethsemane, he started crying because he knew the pain that he had to go through. You see, we don't know. I tell people jokingly, if you knew when you were going to die, you do everything. You want to party all week? You party. So he said, well, next week I'm going to die, so I'm going to chill out and get into the Word of God. Because you know that the end is coming, so you want to get right with God so you have your pathway to heaven. Amen? Is that the truth? But Jesus knew what he had to go through. And he went to the Garden of Gethsemane and he started praying. And his father, if you would take this away from me, he got scared. He got to the point that he was crying so much and he started sweating because he knew what was coming next, the crucifixion, the beating, the straps on his back. He knew what he was going to go through. And he started crying. And it said, the Bible says that blood, it wasn't regular tears, it was blood.
Amen.
They started coming out of him. But what did he say? Forgive me, Lord, because he recognized the weakness because he was in the flesh. He was still a human person. But he said, forgive me, let your will be done.
Amen.
You see?
Amen.
Your will be done. Because he knew that he had to do it for us. You see, he had to go through that. He was a sacrificial lamb. Amen?
Amen.
Is that the truth? Amen. Now, his faith, remember, he's a human being now. He's in a flesh body, but he's a son of God. But you know what? His faith was tested then. Even when the devil, remember I talked about last week? He said, just bow down to me and I'll give you the kingdoms and all this earth. And he said, get thee behind me, Satan. I said, that's what we got to say when we're going through stuff, is get thee behind me, Satan. Because the only way the enemy can come into you is through here. That's why the Bible says that we don't fight against flesh and blood, but what? Principalities and things in the air. Amen. But let me continue. We know that faith is not a magic wand or something that you attain or a personal desire just from God, but it's with confidence, humility, and submission and asking for the blessings that is needed in order to fulfill the purpose he has for us.
Amen.
To carry out the mission he has assigned us to and to walk in the fullness of all his promises and his word as our lives, in our lives. Amen?
Amen.
Y'all getting me so far?
Amen. Amen.
Faith is believing, right?
Amen.
Faith and believing are not the same. Now, a person can believe with their minds that Jesus is the Son of God. You see where I'm going with this. Yet, never believe with their hearts and ask them into their lives to receive salvation. Amen?
Amen.
Faith is stepping beyond belief, right?
Amen.
Faith is putting belief into what? Action.
That's it.
Yeah.
You see? If you don't do the action, nothing gonna happen.
No.
If I don't get up this morning, get suited up and be a priest, nothing gonna happen, right? People come in, they're gonna, what happened to the pastor? He showed up to church. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But faith is that I have faith, okay, I'm gonna get up and do what I gotta do. Amen. So you got to take the action in order for faith to start working. Now, we talk about hope. I hope I can do this. I hope I can do that. Who said that? Anybody ever said, I hope I can do this? Everyone in this room, right? And who's watching my video. But what do? I hope I can do this. Now, hope and faith got to work together. You see, because hope and faith goes right into faith. You understand what I'm saying? Hope and faith goes right into it. Amen. And I'll show
Amen.
You. It says, now never believe, but they believe, you know, in their mind, okay, Jesus exists. I've read it. I've heard it. You know, I know there's a higher being. I've heard that from so many people. But yet they believe, but it's not in here. You see, the Bible says that when we accept Jesus Christ, he comes what? Into your heart. He transforms you. He renews you. Now you become perfect. When I met Natasha,
yep.
I said, man, she's good looking. I like her. We started having a relationship, and then we started what? Falling in love. Amen, right? Now I have a love for her. So if anything comes against her, I'll be the first one to stand in front of her to let that thing happen to me before I let it happen to her. Just like, well, moms and dads. If God forbid, I hate this word, cancer.
Right.
But if cancer comes on our child, we will say, Lord, take it from my child. Put it on me. You see, that's love. Because you're not just doing it because of the mind, you're doing it because of your heart. You see, and it's important that we understand that. And this is what Jesus is talking about in this text. And what I came up with, the realization of what he means.
Right.
See, the Bible, when the more you read it, the more revelation you get, the more knowledge. What that really means is understanding.
That's
and then
right.
God can speak into your life. But he says what? That many believe in their minds, but they don't believe in their hearts. And salvation. And faith is stepping beyond our beliefs, and faith is putting our faith into action. Now, knowing the Word of God, believing the Word of God, amen. I'm going to say that again. Knowing the Word of God and believing the Word of God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. That's all you got to do.
Amen.
Amen. You see, I believe the more you study, the more you pray, the more you seek after God,
right,
the more He'll open up to you. The more He'll show you who He is.
I believe it.
Is that the truth?
Yes.
I got saved 30-some years ago. I'm still standing strong today. Thank you, Jesus. Why? Because I'm constantly in the Word of God. Not that I'm perfect. I fell down, but I don't fall down like I used to. You see? Now I get up. You know, I don't have to get up that many times. Before, I fell down about 20 times a day, maybe 100. But I've learned to, you know, now maybe 3 or 4. It's a big difference. Amen. Of mistakes that we do, because we're still here on this earth. We're still flesh. But we have what? The Holy Spirit that's within us. And what? A relationship, not a belief in the mind, but a relationship from the heart and the mind, and soul and body. So then God can come in and put His Spirit in you. I know these are one of the funny things that I'm always preaching or goofing, but this is a serious thing. It's about our faith and belief, because I see so many people lose faith so quickly. You know, when they're going through something, you know, everything is fine. They're hunky-dory. When something bad happens, they tend to lose their faith because they say, God, why you... Let me not jump ahead of myself. God, why are you not answering my prayer?
Right.
Let me get to that.
Yep.
All right?
Amen.
Now, it is not the same of having faith in the Word of God and putting that faith into action. Faith is taking what we believe and acting on it. I'm going to say that again. Faith is what? Acting on it. Remember those two words. Acting on it. Amen. You have to act on it. You see, if you got to work, you got to work in order to get that money. If you don't work, you ain't going to get no money. If you don't go to study. So it costs you something. Life, he didn't say he'd make it easy. Amen. I say, how the hell is this just me?
No, I'm just telling
you. Amen. Okay, 7 meters. I need some milk. Amen. Now, let me say this. Putting faith into action. Faith is taking what we believe and acting on it. Faith moves from one area to another area. Amen. And also into what? The most important thing is to the spiritual realm. Amen. Now, when some do not receive an answer, you ever pray for someone, you say, God, why you haven't answered my prayer?
Amen.
You see? And this is where I'm getting to. Now I'll explain this to you. It says, now, some of us don't receive an answer to our prayer, and we begin to doubt the Word of God is truth. You start doubting.
Right.
Is that the truth? We're human beings. We're not perfect, but we start doubting. You say, wait a minute, I've been praying for something, nothing's happened. Did you get to a point you say, you know what? I'm going to stop praying for that thing. Because if I keep praying, I've been praying for 6 or 7 months and nothing's happened. You see, that's the problem. I say we live in an age that the enemy comes, and we know that we don't fight against what? Flesh and blood, but principality. And the age that everything is moving fast. You want your coffee now. You want McDonald's now.
No.
You want everything now. You don't need the computer. It goes to how fast it goes now?
Fast.
Well, you want it faster. You're still not satisfied. You see, because if they give a commercial and say, well, we're going to do it faster than AT&T. You know, well, then I'm going to shoot to that.
No,
you know, you want it now. Because it wins.
Yes, exactly.
God forbid we have drive-through churches. You come in, you got to slap me with some water.
Oh, God, I'm telling
you now. You know, slap me with some water. Just say, in the name of Jesus, go ahead and you drop it. Because you don't want to listen to the word. That's what the enemy wants. People perish because what?
Lack of knowledge.
What?
Lack of knowledge.
Lack of knowledge.